Hello, everybody. So glad that you joined us tonight. And I am with Lane Rogers. If you've watched her if you haven't watched her broadcast before, you must go back and type in the best Lane Rogers, and you'll be able to hear so much about her. I'll just give you a little bit of rundown. Businesswoman, her husband and her own large company called Carriage Customs Homes, and they also have two rehabs, a women's center and a men's center. And we've been all over the world together doing mission work for many years. So when you've heard BFF, this is my BFF now. We don't get to spend that much time together, but we are en route. We have been en route to Louisiana to minister. But now there's a large hurricane coming through from what we're being told. So we're camping out here tonight and just going to spend some time with you. So the name of our devotion tonight is called Face Down. When I say face down, what does that mean to you, Lane?
Oh, it means that, I don't know, it means that you have to face down whatever you're afraid of. You have to be able to look it in the face and face it down.
Okay, that's exactly what it means. It's like you confront the opposing, your opponent, or until they relent. Mm-hmm. And you have to be, at one point, you have to just be confident in the Lord. You really do. Mm-hmm. And you have to look at them boldly, and in this case it's fear. And understand this, you can't change what you're unwilling to confront. So we can be bombarded with fear every single day. Mm-hmm. So Lane, what are some things that you've struggled with in the line of fear?
Shorter program, things I haven't struggled with. There's only probably two things that I'm not afraid of, and that's food and water. I can swim, so I'm not afraid of water, and I love to eat. So those two things I'm sure not afraid of.
Well, you know, when you face something down, and again, we're talking about fear, you have to appear strong and confident mm-hmm. against someone else's threats. And mm-hmm. so we know our adversary is the devil, mm-hmm. and we've heard from Joyce Meyer for many years that fear, F-E-A-R, is false evidence appearing real. It's not even real, mm-hmm. but it's the number one tactic that Satan uses against God's mm-hmm. people to keep them from getting up. And Lane, you expressed that one of your fears was talking to people.
Oh, yeah. One of the scariest things that I've ever had to go through was Rick McNeely, Debbie's husband. We went to Trinidad on a missions trip.
Yes.
And he had me to speak not to one church on Sunday morning, but to two churches on Sunday uh-huh. morning. And I was scared to death. I mean, I drove the poor guy driving me crazy. I was like, I can't do this. I really can't do this. I'm scared. I had my hands rolling, my face rolling, everything was rolling. I can't do it. And, you know, and then I started praying. And I got a little stronger, and I made it through the first service. Well, by the time I got to the second service, I walked in, and the man, the pastor said, "Oh, it looks like our speaker is here." And I went, and he saw my face, you know, the eyes rolled and all of it. And he said, "Maybe we should sing one more song and give her a chance to catch her breath." And I thank the Lord for that. And, you know, I got up, and after I got started, the whole thing is you've got to start somewhere.
That's right, that's right.
I was scared because, I was afraid to get started. But once you get started, God will help you take the next step. You just got to reach out a little bit.
That's
you know,
right.
If the man had never put his foot in the Red Sea, it wouldn't have parted.
That's
but,
right.
But, you know, we got to step our foot out. We got to move so we can, you know, we
that's
can
right.
face it.
That's right. Well, you know, Proverbs 3:25-26 says you need not be afraid of sudden disaster or the destruction that comes upon the wicked, for the Lord is your security. He will keep your foot from being caught in a trap. And so when it says sudden, it means quickly, the wink of an eye, and unexpectedly. So what it's saying is sudden. Sometimes something can come on you sudden. Mm-hmm. And Lane, you can tell us many stories when something came on you sudden, and you know, you may not have felt like you were prepared for it. And we've got some funny stories together. Let me tell you, one of Lane's fears has been cats. And so I have to tell you our experience that she had to face down her adversary, which at this point it was a cat, because, see, God was going to use them to open up a soup kitchen. Mm-hmm. And little did she know she had to contend with plenty of cats mm-hmm. around that place. Mm-hmm. But first she had to face one of the biggest cats she's ever seen. Okay, and this cat could have been called fear as far as she was concerned. Mm-hmm. We were, Lane, you and I were driving to see a friend that had been in a car accident right. in Africa. So it was on a mission trip. Mm-hmm. And so we went to see her. She had what, broken leg and jaw and yeah. And you know, I forgot to forewarn Lane that our friend had cats, and not only cats but big dogs. And Lane was, are you scared of dogs?
Oh yeah.
And so when we opened the door, look, there was a big cat staring us in the face, and I show me your eyes, you know. And I knew, I was like, oh no, I forgot all about this. Well, I'm just going to tell you, we were with her, with Barb, our friend, precious friend, and the whole time, because see, fear could smell her in a sense, and the whole time the cats wanted to be around her. They would climb on the back of the couch, and they wanted to get next to her because they knew she was afraid. Well, then the room we slept in had birds in it. And so the cats wanted to keep getting in the room with the birds where we were at. So Lane, you know, tell us about that. How did you deal with it? Because she had to face it.
Well, I was scared to death. First of all, Debbie forgot to tell me that she had a cat. And you know, Barb, to be honest with you, it's the size of a mountain lion. And to me, it was even bigger than that. Because I was afraid of it. I love animals. I don't want anyone to hurt an animal because I do love them. I just don't want to touch them because they scare me. But anyway, so when we got in the house, we realized that Barb didn't just have one cat. She had two cats. And they were both good size. And I was terrified the whole time. And so we did sleep in a bed that had birds. The bedroom had birds in it. So the cats all night were screeching kind of at the door. You know how cats do. And so it made me sick, you know, because I was so afraid. This is what fear. One thing that fear does to you, it makes you ill, physically ill. It made me physically ill. So I had to go to the bathroom. And so Debbie would have to go to the bathroom with me because I wasn't going out with the cats by myself. And all night, I would have to get up. Debbie would have to go with me back and forth to the bathroom because I was so afraid. I realized that I saw them in another room and they were eating. And I would say, feed the cats. Debbie, feed the cats. You know, because if they were eating,
they wouldn't be distracted.
Yeah, they wouldn't bother me if they were eating. But I made it through that. And, you know, sometimes we have to just realize that if we face down our fear,
that's right,
we can make it through. You know, with the help of God, we can make it through. You know, mine is cats. Mine's a lot of things. Cats, heights. I mean, I can go on endlessly about my fears. But God helps us through every one of them.
That's
he
right.
He really does, if we allow him.
Well, we have to share, too, that the dogs got out and was chasing the cats. And I'm right in the middle. I've got Lane right in the middle protecting her. I felt like the cat patrol. And, you know, and of course they love animals and live on a farm, and it's beautiful.
It is.
But this was your fear. This is what your struggle was. But see, she had to face it, like I said, because then God was preparing her to open up a place where you had to face him down.
Mm-hmm.
And instead of saying, you know, what if, we have to say, so what? You do it afraid. Mm-hmm. Even when you feel that, you have to face down your fears, or you will always be bombarded with it. You know, Proverbs 28:1 says, the wicked run away when no one is chasing them, but the godly are as bold as lions. Mm-hmm. And so he's calling us to be bold. You know, he's given us that right. You know, he said through Christ, we've been given access and boldness. Mm-hmm. And confidence through the faith of Jesus Christ. And so, you know, that access is the right that we have to enter. The boldness is outspoken assurance. Mm-hmm. And that's what he's saying, that, you know, you don't be afraid. Confidence is that freedom from doubt. Mm-hmm. Because he said, I've given you the power. In 2 Timothy 1:7 says, the Lord has not given us a spirit of fear, but of power and of love and of a sound mind. So you have to face it down. You can't crawl into a hole. Mm-hmm. So Lane, tell us about, you know, the times that, you know, you had to, I mean, how did you face it down? Because, especially being a, I mean, your mouth makes you a lot of money now. So yeah. How do you do it?
You know, I was young, I was raised poor. And so I know I had an inferiority complex, you know, around people. It was hard for me to speak up around people. Well, you know, later in life, God had a plan for my life that I was going to use my mouth to make money. I sell real estate, and so I have to be able to meet people and talk to people.
Right.
And so I, you know, even part of it, you know, I've done this for 45 years, but part of it was even standing up before people that Rick made me do that time.
Right.
You know, he didn't make me, but I mean, he asked me and I did it.
He's put me in that position several times too.
But you know what? Once you do it, you can get through it because you said, I've done that. You know, it was like David when he said, look, I've seen that bear. I've seen all that stuff.
Yes.
And what is a giant to me?
That's right.
And that's what fear is. It becomes a giant to you.
Yes.
But David knew that he had already overcome a bunch of stuff, so he could do it. And when you get where you can, you know, when you can get up and you can speak to people, well, then you can surely speak to two people or three people,
that's right,
whatever you have to do, because you've already overcome some stuff.
I love that. See, 1 John 4:4 says, you are of God, little children, and have overcome them, because he who is in you is greater than he who is in the
that's
world.
Right.
And that's what he's trying to get the message across to us, because we can roll over and play dead, you know, or we can crawl in a hole somewhere, mm-hmm, or, you know, have our head in the sand. But he's saying, get up, face down your fears. Mm-hmm. It does not have power over you. Mm-hmm. Proverbs 3:24 says, you can go to bed without fear. You can lie down and sleep soundly. How many times when we're trying to go to sleep at night,
mm-hmm,
Lane, you can talk about this, right?
Mm-hmm.
You know, and just wondering maybe sometimes where our children are
right
at, or tell us about that.
Well, you know, I have two daughters that's messed up royally, and a lot of people do. That's what I do. I work in the recovery business, and, you know, at night I remember going to bed and thinking, where are they? Are they okay?
Yeah.
You know, are they dead? Does someone have them? Is someone abusing them? Does some man have them being mean to them? What's going on? And, you know, that would all run through my mind over and over and over again. You know, and then when I started saying, God, I know that you have this.
Yes.
I know
yes.
that you have it. I even drew a little circle on my mirror, and it's been there for years. And I take my finger and I roll that finger around that circle, and I say, Lord, anything in this circle belongs
Ooh,
to you.
That's right.
And
that's
I don't
good.
Have to be afraid.
That's
I don't
right.
have to be afraid, because you've got them. He loves them more than I do. And I'm not saying I'm perfect. I'm not saying there's some nights I don't have to still speak
All
to
of
it.
Us.
I still
yes.
have to speak to it and say, you know, once you get through it, that doesn't mean it's never coming
That's
back.
Right.
But you speak it down every time. You set it back down and let
That's
it know
right.
that, you know, I've got, that with the help of Jesus, we've got this.
That's right. Well, there's two things that you can do with fear, and it's an acrostic. I love this. F-E-A-R, you can forget everything and run, or you can face everything and rise. So you have mm-hmm. to face mm-hmm. down the adversary. It's, mm-hmm. I mean, it will paralyze you, you know, unless you choose, you know, to get up and say, not today, you mm-hmm. know. And when you do that, I mean, and you use the name of Jesus in mm-hmm. Jesus' name. And, you know, that's true. Lane, have you ever felt the fear and you can taste it, you know what I'm
mm-hmm.
saying?
Mm-hmm.
And then you start saying, Jesus.
Mm-hmm.
Jesus,
mm-hmm.
Jesus. Even as I'm saying it right now, I feel it all through mm-hmm. my body, because there's power in that name.
Mm-hmm.
The devils, they know that name. Let me tell you something. They fear and they tremble.
Mm-hmm.
And so when we say it, listen, we're not coming on our own and
mm-hmm.
saying, you know,
right.
I'm fixing to, you know, mm-hmm. whip the devil or whatever. No,
right.
we come through the name of Jesus,
mm-hmm.
and that's when he has to flee.
How many times have you been close to a car wreck?
Oh.
And you couldn't get anything out. You know, you didn't have time to say, oh, most heavenly
That's
Father.
Right.
You didn't have, Jesus!
Yes.
I mean, I've done, I ride with Doug Rogers. I have done this lots of times. Foot on the brake on the passenger
yes.
side. Jesus!
right.
And you know what? Immediately.
That's
I know
right.
he's got it.
That's right.
And that's the thing. Immediately, you know, you say his name, there's power in the name.
That's,
I can sure
that's
tell you
right.
that.
Well, when you say that, it reminds me of when our little girl was, when Bethany, our daughter, was 2 years old, and my sister lived just a piece down from my parents' house, and she had Jonathan, who was an infant at that time, and they were just walking to her house, just a few yards, really, and Bethany slipped out of her hand and ran across the main road in our little town. It's a little town, but there's still traffic that goes across, and all Becky had time to do was say, Jesus, and that car stopped just inches, a couple inches from our daughter's head. And but see, there's power mm-hmm. in that name. So mm-hmm. you know, some of you may be experiencing fear yeah. right now, and you may, I mean, just of tomorrow. What are we going to do? Mm-hmm. You may be listening to the news yeah. and feel like, well, what are we going to do? Mm-hmm. But God has this. Mm-hmm. He said, you know, David said, I was young and now I'm old, and I've never seen the righteous forsaken nor God's seed begging bread. Right. But God is saying, I need you to trust me. Mm-hmm. I need you to trust me. You know, he has this. Mm-hmm. I can promise you that. So, you know, how do we face down our fear? We get our face down in prayer, mm-hmm. right? Mm-hmm. And that's that humble, reverence mm-hmm. position. And when we rise up, we're as bold as a lion, mm-hmm. and the devil cannot hold us in that position mm-hmm. of where we're shaking in our boots. So, Lane, you know, give us some, because listen, when you get back up, that courage rises, and mm-hmm. you feel that confidence. I mean, think about who's your daddy, who your father is.
That's right.
You know, he has got you taken mm-hmm. care of. And mm-hmm. I love what you said about drawing a circle around mm-hmm. your family. Mm-hmm. You know, begin to visualize that mm-hmm. and saying, God, you know, because you've dedicated your children to the Lord.
Right.
And you've seen God do some miracles in mm-hmm. your family. Mm-hmm. And especially you're planting into other children, other mm-hmm. people's life, other men and women's mm-hmm. lives. And so, you know, you give and it shall be given to you. You're seeing that happen as well.
Right.
So would you give us some wisdom on what's helped you through all the fears that the enemy tried to bombard you? Because listen, you do big things for God, Lane. And so that's the thing is the first thing you're going to do is fear. But you know, part of that is God, I can't do this on my own. And that's where a dependency we have on mm-hmm. God, but there's a difference in depending upon him and then being afraid mm-hmm. to step out.
Mm-hmm. You know, I started the recovery centers for people that had all kinds of problems. And my children are two of the people that have those kind of problems. But you know what? I'm not afraid.
Yes.
Because I know in whom I trust.
Come on.
And if you know in
yes.
whom you trust, you don't have to be afraid. I'm still not going to touch a cat. I'm going to be honest with you. I'm still not going to touch a cat. Going up on
I'll touch it for her.
Yeah, she'll touch it. She will touch anything. Tarantulas, cats, it doesn't matter. No, I don't like heights. I've been on the Eiffel Tower. My son said, come on up. It may be the last time you ever get to go. Well, I've been back and I did it again, you know. So I've been on the Eiffel Tower and it's really tall, y'all. And when you're going up on the elevator, you can see all the way down on the ground. It's scary. But I did it.
Yeah,
you know
what? You jumped off a bridge.
I jumped off a bridge when I was a child.
When she was a kid, not yet.
That was really stupid. Yeah, that was peer
pressure. That was peer pressure.
Peer pressure, another program.
Yeah, peer pressure and peer pressure. Yeah, exactly. But Lane, would you lead us in prayer? Because some of you may be experiencing that right now. And, you know, like I was saying earlier, sometimes, look, you just have to, you can only take the news in small portions, mm-hmm. you know, and you just got to say, God, you are the one in control. I'm telling you. He's got everything in control. He wants you to relax and just listen to him. Listen what he's telling you to do and be at peace.
Amen. You know, I've got to say this. If we watch the news all the time,
yes,
24/7, if that's all you do is watch
that's
the news,
right.
you're going to live in fear.
That's right.
But you know what? If you'll pick up your Bible,
yes.
you know you don't have anything to fear, because in the very back, I know what it says, and we win.
Yes.
So, you know, when my husband plays a lot of softball games, when we start playing, we don't know if we're going to win or lose, but this is a battle that I know I win.
Come on.
Automatically, I win.
That's right.
And I am so thankful. Lord, I thank
you, Jesus.
I thank you that we are all winners.
Hallelujah.
We have no reason to be afraid, because you walk with us every
yes.
day. And I thank you for being here for us. Lord, I love you. And Lord, if there's anyone out there that's hearing my voice, that's afraid
yes,
of what's going on in this world today,
yes.
help them to turn.
Yes.
Turn everything to you, Lord, because you are that. You are a helper. Lord, you're the one that's
yes.
going to keep us through all of this. And all we have to do is depend. Put our faith, our
yes.
trust, and depend on you, because you got it. In Jesus'
thank you,
name.
Jesus.
Amen.
Amen. That's awesome. Listen, we love you. Thank you for spending some time with us tonight. God loves you, and have a great rest of your evening. All right? Okay, bye-bye.
Bye.